Happy Sunday, you guys. I'm so excited to stretch it with you. Hey, Marnie. Hey, Lisa. Good morning, Akiko. Glad you guys are here. For today's session, we're going to use something to roll out your foot. So whether you have a tennis ball, a golf ball, something, a rolling pin. That was a great joke last time, but it works. So you can use a rolling pin to roll out, or I'm going to be using a TheraBand roller to roll out today. And then you want something, a towel. In fact, I'll grab one to show you. A towel, you could use a band loop, a band. Good morning, Paige. To stretch, we're going to do some IT band stretches today. So as we talk about with our stretching session, if you can do something to make your space calm. Good morning, Edie. Whether that's opening a window, dimming the lights, lighting a candle, whatever you can do to make it kind of feel like you're setting the intention. And then we're going to start with the rollout of your foot. Now, if you don't have, so take your right foot and just start to roll forward and back. If you don't have something to roll out your feet, do the same rolling motion on your feet. So you would roll yourself forward and back. We'll go to the outer rim and you'll do the same. Good morning, Melissa. And then you'll do the same on the inside, just like we roll through. So again, whether you have a tennis ball underneath your foot and you're rolling through the center or that outer rim. We might have a little puppy intruder in a second. We'll see. Now start to roll out to the outside rim of the foot. So about a month ago, we talked about that if you don't have something to roll your foot out, that you could use the end of a wooden spoon or anything that has a little bit of a curved edge, and then you would be seated, and then you would just go through in a seated position and kind of run the spoon or the edge of the tool across the outside edge of your foot. You'll find some hot spots that you want to kind of work out, press into, and then come into the inside.
Please, come here.
Come to the inside. She says, good stretching, everybody.
Please, come here.
My son obviously didn't read his text messages.
Please, come here.
And then dig into the heel. See, we all need a haircut, even Gracie. Gracie needs a haircut. And then go, so with the heel, you'll notice when you're on the heel, there's generally some crunchy stuff that we have to work through. Marnie says, hi, Ben. He says, hi, Marnie. I texted him, he left for a walk, and I forgot to let him know that we would be here together. And sometimes it's crazy when they come back home. So I texted him to come in the garage or the back door, but apparently that message didn't get through. Now start to go into the arch of the foot. So with the arch of the foot, again, you're rolling that middle portion, and you can easily miss the whole advantage of that rollout. So think it may be that you stand your weight on your tool, stand on it and come off of it and find that tightness in the band of muscles that attaches the heel to the ball of the foot. Marnie, they should have the link for what he's been working on with Lion King, I think June 7th. So as soon as I have that, we'll have to have a Lion King viewing Zoom party. And then go into the ball of the foot, big toe to pinky toe, kneading your way from that inside edge all the way to that outside edge. Again, you want to watch that you're not just rolling quickly from spot to spot. You'll miss it. So as you're going from toe to toe, find where you have more of an issue through that foot and then spend some time there. Right now, Ben does all of his filming for the play in here. So he does his filming on this wall because it can't have any distraction. And so transitioning us quick from one filming to the next is pretty entertaining. And then take your weight, roll all the way front to back. Dig in a little bit deeper, meaning don't stand on this left leg. Press into the right leg and see if you can get that to work out just a little bit more. And before we go to the other foot, we're going, I know, me too, Marnie. I feel like you can hear it, but we're gonna do a few different stretches today that might go after some different stuff. We've been doing a lot of strength work in different ways this week and the week before. So we're gonna do some stretches that are a little bit different. Make note of the ones that you feel are more effective for you so you can do those more this week. Now, before we go to the other foot, find a hard surface, so get off your mat and stand on the ground and compare the foot you've rolled out to the foot you have not. The more issues you have in your foot, the bigger that contrast. So the work foot we've just done should kind of melt into the floor. The foot falls all into the ground. And then the other foot, you'll still feel that it's not connected to the ground in the same way. And then we'll go after that with the left foot. So you start all the way heel to toe, working it out first. And again, remember, we start with the feet, because if we can get the feet to loosen up and work out, then as we stretch the body from the feet up, it will all have a little bit more mobility. So that's our goal. Some, depending if you're on a golf ball, that's going to be really very effective and maybe potentially a little bit painful. So when you're on a hard, firmer surface, you may need to take it off, shake it out for a second, and then come back to it so that the foot doesn't grip and keep you from getting into those hot spots. And then roll to the outside rim of the foot. All that stuff that feels crunchy or just a little uncomfortable, pause and knee back and forth over that. So you intentionally want to work into those spots that are just a little bit more uncomfortable. And then roll onto the inside rim of the foot. Heel to toe. The spots that need more attention, pause there. And then go after the heel. Now that's generally where you find most of those little crunchy spots. A lot happening in your feet, and then especially when we do a lot of our agility work, the feet tighten up. So same thing, when you're rolling out that heel, you could take the heel and kind of dig to the outside, dig to the inside, find where you have more hot spots, and then hang out there. And then go after the arch. The arch is that one spot that you may want to transfer your weight onto your apparatus. So you may come off that right leg standing on your rolling pin, your ball, whatever it is you have. Stand on it, come off of it, move it inch by inch, find where you can release and go after the tightness from the muscles that attach the ball of the foot to the heel. And then lastly, the ball of the foot, roll from toe to toe, big toe, work your way from toe to toe all the way to the pinky. If there's one spot that needs more time, pause there. Oh, yay. So fun that you get some time with your niece, Lisa. Such a good aunt. And then roll from the heel to the toes. Lisa, I meant to text you and ask you what your niece's name is, because I feel like I always want to thank her for stretching with us, but then I only know that she's Lisa's niece. So if there's a minute in your pause. That Lily? Yes. Oh, what a sweet name. Lily, thank you for stretching with us. So cool you get to hang out together. Someday maybe we can all be really together. That would be fun. And then take your weight. So as you're rolling all the way from heel to toe, take your weight, push into your roller just a little stronger. And then you're going to come off of your apparatus and come to the side and feel how your feet feel on the ground here. Now, again, for those of you who have a tighter situation with your feet, then you want to do that more often. I know it's hard to make time. We're going to find a wall. So hopefully all of you have a wall or a chair or something you can lean into. We're going to find a wall just to do a little bit of a side bend IT band stretch. We've been doing a lot of core today, which makes our hips tight all the way from the foot to the head. So you're going to take, stand so that your left leg or your outside leg is about a foot or a foot and a half from the wall. You can change that as we go into the stretch. Your inside leg comes out and away behind the outside leg. So my left leg is my outside leg. If you have a different situation with your wall, just make sure it's the inside leg that comes over. Then take your outside arm and lean it into the wall. Now you're pushing into the wall to create pressure so this left outside hip stretches out just a little bit deeper. So when you push into that wall, breathe and try and let go. It will stay gripping, so it's gonna stay to where you can't get into it, and you have to use your inhalation and your exhalation to let go and push. As we breathe, you'll be able to take the hips farther away from the wall. Now, if I don't have a wall and I'm in this stretch, that's great too. The wall gives you some resistance that you otherwise don't have, but it's great to be in that side bend as well. Inhale. Exhale, see if you can lean that left hip, that outside hip out just a little bit bigger. One more big deep breath in. Exhale. Now, keep your feet as they are. Come center, let go of the wall, and reach towards your feet. So you have that left foot in front, the right foot behind, and you just reach towards the ground. Inhale. Exhale, pull your tailbone up towards the ceiling just a little bit deeper. One more time, big deep breath in. Exhale, roll yourselves up. As you roll up, squeeze your glutes, pull your abs in, roll the shoulders back and down. Now I'm going to go to another roll, but you can just turn around. So in that, now you come same position. You have that outside leg as your stabilizer. Your inside leg comes behind. So my left leg is behind my right. Then my right hand comes into the wall and pushes away so that I have a deepening of the stretch in that right hip. And then I inhale and exhale. So each time I breathe in and out, I'm trying to see if I can let go of that hip and lean my upper body into the wall and my torso, my hip away from the wall. Same option without a wall, side bend. That left hand can grab onto the right and pull. Thanks, Lisa. I know I was researching after requests yesterday. I was researching some stretches, so hopefully we have some ones that'll go after different people's tightness. So in this, if you move your hips forward and back a little bit, side to side, you'll find where you grip tighter in that lateral position. So go after that, draw the hips back, see what that feels like for you. Draw the hips forward. One more big deep breath in, Exhale, see if you can push that right hip away a little bigger. Now let go of your wall. Keep your feet as is and dangle the arms. So as you come into that, you have your right foot in front, your left foot behind. Reach the hands. Some of you will be here. Some of you here. Some of you can take your hands flat on the floor beyond where I can reach. So again, you find your position. Let go of the neck, the head. See if you can push a little weight into your back leg. Inhale. Exhale, slowly roll yourselves all the way up. Squeeze your glutes, pull your belly button in. Roll your shoulders back and down, unwrap the feet. So now your feet, about hip width apart, roll up onto the balls of the feet. So when you come into that, you find that position where you roll up. Then we roll back, lift the toes, engaging the anterior tibialis, front of the shin. Roll out, you're on the outer rim. Roll in, and then settle in the center. Reset your feet. Deep breath in, arms up. Exhale, drop the shoulders and hinge. Scoop your belly button in nice and tight. Round your back. Soften your left knee. Your left hand comes down to the floor. Your right hand comes up to the ceiling. Inhale. Exhale. One more big deep breath in. Exhale, both hands come down, straighten both legs if you can. Relax the back of the neck. Bend your right knee, right hand stays down, left hand comes up. Inhale. Exhale. One more big deep breath in. Exhale, both hands come down to the floor. One vertebrae at a time, roll yourselves up, squeeze your glutes, pull your belly button in, roll your shoulders back and down. Oh, thank you, Edie. There's more, but wait, there's more. Come to the back of your mat, so whatever direction you're facing is great. Take a deep breath in, arms come up. Exhale, drop the shoulders and hinge. Scoop your belly button in, round your back, drop the hands. Walk your hands forward, high hover. Don't worry, Alex, we're not gonna do tons of push-ups. I promise. Low hover. High hover. Inverted V pushback. Peel your tailbone up towards the ceiling and try and press your heels towards the ground. You can walk the feet. You can do a little treading. Loosen up the calves into the Achilles. Then center your weight. Slide back forward onto that high hover position. Low hover. Press your chest through. Hold the weight up for a second. So we're trying to keep the knees off the floor. Feel the weight of the hips get heavy and pull the hip flexors a little bit. Big deep breath in. And then exhale, set the knees down. Flatten your feet. Keep that big lift. And hinge back into that child's pose. So as you come back into that child's pose, feel the weight of the tailbone get heavy. You're tucking the hips under so that you can stretch that lumbar spine. Flip your palms so that your hands are palms to the ceiling. Let the weight of the shoulders go. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Now turn the hands so that the palms are back down. Slide so that you're on your left hip. Now once you're on your left hip, bend your left knee a little bit. We're going to take this right leg, straighten it, turn it down, let it drop to the floor. So we're just creating a little bit of a spinal twist. So that right leg, foot flexed, angled down and behind, and then reach that right arm away. So you're trying to reach the toe and the fingertip as far as you can. Big deep breath in. Exhale. You could do that all the way down if you wanted as well. Inhale. Exhale. See if you can reach the hand a little bit farther. And from there, engage and come into that hip so that you're extending the hip flexors. Squeeze the glutes, straighten your bottom leg. Pull this right leg back just a little bit and then drop it down towards the floor. So instead of it being popped up here, you're pulling back and down. Same thing, I can do all that down here. I could grab a towel or a pillow, put that underneath my neck for comfort. You find what serves you. Inhale. Exhale, keep the grip, turn onto your stomach, kick the foot into the hand, and then lift the head, lift that right knee. Inhale. Exhale, release that. Now turn to the other side. So now you have that right hip underneath you. The left leg lifts up. You're going to bend to the right, flex the foot, tip the toe down. So we're just trying to go into a little bit of a rotation. Drop the foot behind. That just lengthens, creates a pull so that we do a push-pull coming into that quadricep hip flexor stretch. Now reach. Create length from the fingertip, intercostals, obliques, the hip. Remember, I could be down here. Inhale, go as long as you can. Big reach. And then exhale, counter that by reaching behind. Grab onto the foot. You straighten the bottom leg so that right leg is now straight. Pull the thigh so the thigh comes towards the bottom leg, and then see if you can take it back a little bit and drop the knee. Nice big deep breath in. One more time, nice big deep breath in. And then as you exhale, roll onto your stomach. Come forward, kick the foot into the hand. So you're creating a stretch by the strength that you have to kick the foot into the hand. That's gonna stretch the chest and the front of the shoulder. Now lift your head, lift the knee. Inhale. Exhale, come down, release the foot, and then turn over onto your back. And once you're on your back, this is where we talked about having a towel or a band or a strap, anything that can grab onto the foot for that hamstring IT band stretch. So I'll show you with the towel because that's something that we all should have. So with the towel, you hook the foot. So my right foot is in, my left leg is lengthened out. From there, just sit in that hamstring stretch for a moment. If you have a band, I like it doubled so that it's a little firmer resistance because it'll give you a bigger stretch. So with that, you can double the band or just use a hand towel or a towel. Now move the leg around a little bit. Your counterpoints, the things that will increase the stretch, will be taking your tailbone, pressing your tailbone down. So it's gonna wanna lift because the hips are tight, the glutes tight, the hamstrings tight. Take the tailbone, push it into the floor, and feel that tightening from the glute up the hamstring. Now, with your strength, push into your towel. So you're activating the quadricep and the hamstring. Try and fight yourself. You're pushing the towel down or pushing the band down, so what it would look like with the band is you have a little bit more movement. You're pushing. Now release that and pull. Activate the muscle. Push. Release and pull. One more. Activate the muscle. Push down. Release and pull. Now take that right leg out to the right side. So from that position, you're here, you take it out, and then bring the foot up towards your hip. Same thing here. Now your range of motion is going to be different than your neighbor's. So again, it doesn't matter if my knee has to be bent, that's okay. Open up that hip a little bit. Inhale. Exhale, come center. Keep your right hip driven down and then bring that right leg across the left. Now this IT band stretch should be a little uncomfortable. The points to pay attention to. I could lift this all the way off the floor and it would not be as effective for my IT band. So you take the hip, drive the hip down, flex the foot, and then bring the foot over. Now once I drive the hip down, flex the foot, bringing the toes as close to your shin as you can, and then you bring that leg over the midline and then draw the foot towards your head. Those are all points that deepen that stretch. Inhale. Exhale one more time. Come out to the side. Release it. Lengthening out that inner thigh. So when we come into that stretch, you're stretching this bottom leg as well. So you press your left hip down, you pull the right toes up. Inhale. Exhale, come center, drive your right hip down, bring your right leg over. Breathe. Inhale. As you exhale, soften the knee, release the towel, set that foot down, bend the left knee, bring that left foot up. Now we start where you just loosen up in that position, so you just hang out there for a second. You can move it around. You can bend and straighten it. A towel may be too small, a small towel might be too short, depending on how tight you are. So if you need something longer, again, find what serves you this morning. And then we're going to go into that active release. Keep your right hip down. Activate your left leg. So you're pushing against yourself. So right now you're taking that leg, power down, so you're trying to push the towel to the floor. Release and pull the leg in with your arms. So this is the same stretch you would do with the trainer, where they're standing here and they're pushing into the stretch and then you're pushing into them. So it's an active and release stretch. So again, try that using your own resistance. Push your leg down, activate the quad and the hamstring. Now release it and pull. One more time. Activate.
when you activate that hamstring and the quad, you'll also feel a stretch in between the shoulder blades. Release it and pull. Each time after you activate it, it should give you a tiny bit more mobility of that hamstring, of that leg, to be able to come in towards you. Now take that left leg out to the side. Try and keep the right hip down. And then find your position. So whether that's holding on with your right hand or your left hand, the towel or band, find what works for you. You're opening up the hip. When you open up the hip, that inner thigh stretches for the straight leg that's up, but also the leg that's on the ground. Pull it towards your head just a little bit tighter. Inhale. As you exhale, bring the leg center. Now, IT band, press that left hip down. This one's a little painful. Bring the leg across the body. Don't let your left hip float. Flex your foot, straighten your knee. The points of intensity increase when the hip stays down, the leg stays straight, the foot is flexed. We bring it over and then up. Breathe. Now slide once more out to the side. See, as you loosen it up, if you can get just a little bit more mobility. Like I said, that knee could be bent for some. So it could be that you hook the thigh and you have that leg out to the side, but bent. Feel the freedom to move, how it feels good to stretch and give your body some attention to let go. Bring that leg center, and then we come into that uncomfortable stretch. Bring that left leg across the midline. Hip stays down, knee is straight, foot is flexed. Over, and then pull up. The more you drive the tailbone down, the deeper the stretch. Breathe. And soften that left knee. Remove the towel. So now from there, we're going to bend the right knee. Bring the right knee in towards your chest. And then bring the right leg over so it crosses over the left side of the body. Bring the right arm out to the side and then look over that right shoulder. Inhale. Exhale. One more time, big deep breath in. As you exhale, bring that right leg back to center. Now you're going to set your right foot down and then just let that hip hang open. So the right foot is down and the right knee is out to the side. Slide your left foot in and do the same. So you're making that diamond position with your legs. Your feet are together. You can have your feet farther out or closer in and breathe. Let go of the tightness in the hips. Inhale. Exhale, feel the weight of the thighs get heavier and draw the knees closer towards the mat. One more big deep breath in. As you exhale, bring the knees center, straighten your right leg, pull the left knee in, draw the left knee across the right side, and then that right arm, left arm comes up and out. Look over that left shoulder. Every time you exhale, try and let go of that tight back, the tight hip, the quadricep. It'll stay gripped if you let it. We're trying to use the exhalation to let go.
We ask the body to stay strong and tight and contracted all week long. So take a moment to work on the practice of being able to control that and release it. So it's better for our strength if we have the ability to contract and also the ability to let go and release it. One more big deep breath. As you exhale, bring that left leg center, set the left foot down. Now, this activates the IT band as well. Slide both feet in, it's a little uncomfortable. Heel toe your feet out. So you don't want to wrench the feet out. You heel toe, heel toe, heel toe. So the feet are outside the hips and then let the knees drop in. Breathe into that. The weight of the thigh will pull at the hip. It could be that we only have the capacity to do one leg at a time today. That's okay. You could do your left leg, then pull it to center and do your right leg. If you can, both legs come in. Two more big deep breaths. Exhale, let go. One more time, big deep breath in. And exhale, let go. Now this part's important. Don't pull your knees back open. Heel toe back in. We don't want to wrench into that while we've just stretched. Now bring your right foot onto your left knee. Bring the left knee up. Flex the right foot. Use your hands to hook the thigh. For some, this will be plenty of a stretch. So you could always have the foot on the floor. You lift, create that bind. You intensify by pressing your right knee out, pulling your left knee in, and flexing your foot. Inhale. Exhale, press your tailbone deeper into the mat. Now release that bind. Let the feet drop over to the left side. Use your left hand to hook the thigh. It pulls the right thigh a little closer to the floor. And then bring the right arm out to the side and look over it. Inhale, exhale. One more big deep breath in. Exhale, let go of the shoulder weight. Let go of your back, your hip. Now bring your right knee back to the chest, let the left follow, and then switch. The left foot comes onto the right knee, so you're in a figure four stretch there. If that's enough for you, stay. Otherwise, lift, create that hook, the hands come around your right thigh, pull your right thigh in towards you, press your left knee away from you, flex your left foot. Press the tailbone into the mat. Inhale. Exhale. One more big deep breath in. Exhale, release the bind. Take the legs so that left foot
connects to the floor on the right side. Your right hand comes underneath and hooks the left thigh. Your right hand comes up and out to the left side. Look over the left shoulder. Every exhale, let go of the tightness in your neck. Big deep breath in. Exhale. One more big deep breath in. Exhale. Let go of the shoulder, the back, the thigh. Now bring your left knee into your body first, and then let the rest of the body shift back to neutral. Roll yourselves up so you come into a seated position. From there, you have two options. You can reach one leg at a time up so that you're lifting and lengthening the hamstrings. We're almost done. We have two stretches. So you can stay here with that extension for the hamstrings. You could also have your hands behind you if it's too tight to hook the feet or hook the thighs and reach the feet out. Or to loosen up the back, roll back, lift up. So when we tuck and roll, we're trying to loosen up that lumbar spine. Four more. Last three, two, and one. Come up nice and tall. Open up the legs so you reach the legs wide to the side. Lift the body nice and tall, and then lean the body forward. So we're coming into a prep just for that cross-legged position. I'm going to give you a couple options. It's not the best stretch for everybody. So again, you may choose that you want to hang out here. Elbows, forehead to the mat. Flex your feet. Take the tailbone and tip it back a little bit. Or you can bring that right leg in and lean forward here. Or you keep the right leg in and then you bring the left foot on top of it. So again, as we sit in that stretch, you could always have that left foot in front. So play with the different positions and find your perfect spot. And then from that, breathe into it. We're trying to let the weight of this left thigh go so that eventually the knee, the foot, and the hip loosen up and this gap is smaller. Now some of you, you're going to have the foot and the knee touching from the start. Because my hips and knee are tight, it takes a while to get there. And it's a journey that we've been working on. So as we work into that, think about loosening up side to side a little bit in your back. Letting go of that thigh, letting go of the knee. Now take your left hand, sit on it, and then take your right hand and gently pull. So you're drawing your right ear to the right shoulder. Inhale. Exhale. Take that left hand, push it into the floor. Tilt your chin towards that right shoulder. Take your left hand, turn your fingers to the back. There we go, Lisa, with our elbow stretch. If you press the heel of the hand into the floor and pull away from that with your body, so you're taking your body, trying to shift this way, you'll get that to open up in the shoulder, the elbow, the shoulder, and the wrist. Inhale. Exhale, release. Bring that hand back to neutral, shake it out a little bit, and then draw your hands forward. Now for some, I could be just touching the fingertips. Some, the hands come forward. Some can put their elbows on the ground. Inhale. Exhale, let go. Walk your hands back. Take your right leg, reach it out to the side so the right leg comes into extension. And then twist, turn your body towards it. Keep your back nice and straight. And then bow your head towards that left leg. That could mean my hands touch the floor. That could mean my hands touch the calf. Or I come all the way and hook the foot. Some of you will be able to lay on this leg. Great mobility and flexibility if you can. So come into your range. Try and keep your back nice and straight and press into this right hip. Inhale. Exhale, release. Now sit up nice and tall. Bend this left knee. Take the right foot back behind you so it puts you in pigeon. In that stretch, you can be all the way up tall, lifted. You can be all the way down or anywhere in between. Press into your right hip. Inhale. Exhale. One more big deep breath in. And exhale, crawl yourselves back up. Now keeping this left leg on bottom, now the left leg is bent. So remember, you could stay right here. You could bring that right foot in front. You could bring the right foot on top of the left knee. So this is that same stretch, the other leg is now on top. You could shake around, move around a little bit in that, find where you're tight. If you're tight in your obliques or in your back, you could choose to hold a different stretch than I take you into. So again, feel the freedom to find what you need and then just sit in that for a second. From there, take your left hand or right hand, sit on it. Take your left hand, apply a little pressure, pulling your left ear to the left shoulder. Breathe nice and deep. Inhale. Exhale. One more big deep breath in. As you exhale, take the hand out from underneath, then press the heel of the hand into the floor. Must have been cut off with my stretching music. It's because it's a hint from the universe that we're done. So close, so close. Now take this right hand, turn the palms so that the palm has the heel of the hand facing forward and the fingertips facing back. Tilt your chin towards that left shoulder. Inhale. Exhale, see if you can press heavier into that right hand. Lean away from it. Now release the stretch, bring the head to center. Hands come in and shake them out. Then you find that position that feels good, whether that's forward, whether that's your hands, whether that's your elbows. Inhale. Exhale. One more time, big deep breath in. Exhale, bring yourself back to upright. Take this right leg out to the side. Flex the foot, sit up nice and tall, lift your heart, twist your body, and then bow your head towards that right leg. So again, I can pick what that looks like. It could be touching the fingers, crawling my way forward, hooking the foot. Press into this left hip so that that counterpoint gives you a deeper stretch through that rotation, but also through that oblique. Inhale. Exhale, let go. Crawl your hands back, bend to this right knee. Send your left leg back, twist so you rotate into pigeon. I could choose to stay upright. I could come down onto my elbows, all the way on my forehead. Press into your left hip. Inhale. Exhale. One more time, big deep breath in. And exhale, crawl yourselves back up. This time, hands are on the floor. Keep them in place. Send both knees so that you have your knees in that right underneath the hip. And then push back. Crawl your hands forward, stretching in between the shoulder blades. And then come back forward so those knees, once again, are right underneath the hips. From here, take your left foot forward. Last stretch, bringing us into standing. So that left foot comes forward and we press into that, so that you have a nice lengthening from this knee all the way to the back knee. Now, it could be that you move your foot in and rotate a little bit. It could be that you come down towards the mat. Find where you get the deepening of that inner thigh lengthening from knee to knee. Move around it a little bit if you want. Big deep breath in. Exhale, lift your body, press forward. Inhale. Exhale, let go of that right hip. Now bring your hands back down. Send that left knee back, bring the right foot forward. Find the position that serves you in that lunge. So again, knee to knee, you're trying to lengthen from right leg to back leg. You can move around in that. You could drop all the way down if you want. Inhale. Exhale, try and let go of that left hip. Now lift your body, using a little weight change to press this left hip forward. Inhale. Exhale, let go. Hands come back down. Send your right foot back so you're in that hand-to-knee position. Knees are right underneath the hips. Dig the toes into the floor. Lift your tailbone, press back. Hips lift up to the ceiling. Walk your hands back, dangle the arms. Now before you roll up, whatever you can let go of before you start your week, whether that's physical, mental, emotional, let go of what you don't need to hang on to. Relax the muscles in your face, your jaw, your head, shoulders, neck. And then as we roll up, only pick up what you need. Squeeze your glutes, pull your belly button in, roll your shoulders back and down, lift the heart. Take a nice big deep breath in, arms come up. And exhale one more time, big deep breath in, arms up.
And exhale. Good work today, you guys. Thank you so much for being here. Sorry we went a little bit long, but hopefully your legs feel good and you feel like we stretched out and got into those hips a little bit. So as we work through, the upper body is a little bit harder to stretch, and I know that people are, I guess it's not harder to stretch. It's just it doesn't feel as cranky as the other stuff. So as we're working through, thank you, Akiko. As we're working through that, just know that doorway stretch where you can come, or even the corner of a room where you can put your hands on the wall or the doorway and lean in. That will be really good for the chest and the front of the shoulder. And then any of those overhead stretches. Stretch out your hands and your elbows throughout the day if you can, especially if you're sitting at a desk or computer a lot these days on calls. So I love and appreciate you guys. Thank you so much for being here. Just know, again, like we talk about, every day presents itself with a different set of opportunities. So try not to hang on to the stuff that isn't serving you. Let it go, whether that's guilt or shame or frustration with not getting to the things that we want to get to each day. Begin again. Tomorrow's a new day. So we got our stretching in. That's solid. And then I'm excited. I'll be sending out the schedule today for this week. And tomorrow will probably be short, like a Tabata series and something, because I don't know who's with me. But if you're all up for a workout, then text or email me. But anyway, I love you guys. Know that you're on my heart, and I appreciate you showing up and stretching with me. Have a great day.